Well, the weather is finally a little bit warmer, warm enough that we can actually put some paint on the old S12 in the engine bay. Before that, we're gonna go ahead and just make sure the whole engine bay is clean. I already sanded it in the previous, was it yesterday or the day before's vlog? So go ahead and check that out, but we're gonna go ahead and clean it, make sure it's nice and clean. Yeah, mask everything off and let's get to it. All right, guys, well, I'm a little squeezed for room here, but I have the garage door closed. I have everything pretty much, actually it is prepped. I just hit it with a tack rag, cleaned off, went over all the areas, made sure they're all nice and smooth. We'll just do a very light first coat. You guys are pretty much gonna be on time lapse here because I don't really have much room to move the camera here, but I might even just jump to when it's done. So let's get going.
Well, you won't get the full idea for the color yet, because we're in like unnatural light, but this is two coats going well. Third coat coming up. All right, so that was the third coat. I'm gonna do two more. I'm just gonna make them very, very light with like metallic pearly colors. You want to make sure you don't lay it too heavy, because that way the metallics will kind of fold over and lay down, so you won't actually see them. So we're gonna go ahead and just do two very light dustings, and hopefully that should be all the coats we need, and then we can go on to clear coat. But so far so good. All right, well, we're done with the base coat. This color is Millennium Jade. For those of you that are wondering, it is Millennium Jade. Now this color came in on the R34 GTRs, and maybe even the 33s. I don't believe the 32s. I'm sorry about the mask, it's really fumey in here. It will not show, it will not pop until we get the clear coat on it. Now the clear coat that we're using is this stuff. It's like a 2K clear coat in a can, has the activator that you have to break in on the bottom here with this little cap, and so we'll have a nice hardener 2K clear coat going on this thing. Should be sweet.
I'm sorry the lighting is gonna be crap until I go ahead and open the garage door again, but we can't do that until this is done. Let's just go ahead and get to getting glossy, you know?
Perfect amount of clear because we just ran out. So we're gonna let this dry up. We'll open the garage door and you guys will really be able to see this color. Same with me, I still can't really tell with this lighting, but it looks really good for some spray paint.
Well, I'm gonna leave all the bags and stuff there temporarily until it all dries up. I'm pretty stoked. I'm sure, you know, Cody's gonna be pretty happy with it. Even in like this lighting, the camera honestly doesn't even do it justice. It's like this, I mean, Millennium Jade. You guys can look it up and get some like super good pictures of it. But yeah, I mean, I'm pretty happy, guys. It just kind of looks all crazy with all the stuff kind of just chilling in here. But once we have the motor in, which will be the next thing to do here now, just put all, you know, the booster, all the clutch stuff back in, get the lines back mounted up. But I'm going to wait till this really dries up, and we'll go from there. So, as far as painting the S12, complete. So, yesterday, you guys would have seen, if you guys haven't seen yesterday's video, make sure to check it out.
We jimmied up some S14 rain splash guards on the S13 because, as I told you guys, I took my fuse box harness out of the engine bay and it's now routed inside behind the dash. So the grommets that used to be there just are cut up and are not the same anymore. So I used to have a bunch of rain pouring in. But obviously, I mean, it's really hard to see these wheels in there. Oh man, am I really gonna have to take these wheels off? I probably really should have done this yesterday. But you know what, actually, let's just try it here right quick. This is bold. So hang on, let me show you guys what I'm talking about here. So this stuff, wipe new, you know what I mean? You've seen it on TV, the shine lasts for years. So I'm just thinking maybe we should just give it a little try right here. I don't know if you guys can tell, but it's actually really faded. So what do you guys say we, it's really hot. I don't know if it's like good to do it on a hot surface because that's like really hot. But I don't know, let's just wing it, see how it does. All right, so it's always a fun time trying to do this stuff one-handed. Let's see what we got in here. Hopefully it works. There's our juice. Congratulations on your purchase of Wipe New. So, well, good thing I decided to check out these guys. It says, Wipe New is not recommended for application on vehicle. Wow, I messed that up. Wipe New is not recommended for application to vehicle paint. And that part which I was referring to that I was going to look at on wiping new is vehicle paints. So let's just see if we can find anything else that we can quickly wipe new while we're here. They say you can use this like this cowl stuff. I was going to honestly paint it. But should we see how it looks like just wipe nude up? One of these days I do want to tape off like this whole car, get everything masked all around these windows, and go ahead and just replace and just... Unless I can find, no, I'm gonna repaint like this trim stuff, but I really would like to get new like seals. Like there's a little rubber that's so cracked and just dry rotted right there. I really wanna get that changed up. These ones here are pretty good still. I'm actually gonna be getting some nice carbon pieces here, so be on the lookout for that video here very shortly. But yeah, like all this stuff, I really think I just need to repaint it in like some black trim paint or whatever. And then I'm gonna go ahead and rewrap my roof. I don't know if you guys noticed, but it's wrapped. I wrapped it way back. I mean, there's a video on it way, way back. I mean, this is like my only issue with it, really. That little corner popping up. But for my first wrap job, it looks pretty, pretty epic. All right, so I really want to wipe something new, so I'm gonna take this off. Oh, that's rippage there. That's some torque. Yeah, bumper down, nickel there. I'm gonna take off this, what do you want to call it? Windshield thing. And, let's wipe it new. Yep. Mm-hmm. Now if this doesn't work, boy, if it looks just crappy, I'll be pissed. So what do we have to do? Sand it, and then just wipe it new, I guess. Let's do that. Go to our little wipe new station over here. This little gorgeous piece of art there. Again, one-handed, it's always a fun time, so I'm gonna set you guys down on the wipe new display demonstration area. Hang on. Okay. Okay. Well, I want you guys to get a good look before this gets cleaned up here. Oh, we're losing our stuff. That's kind of the finish we got right now. It's really not ideal. Looks pretty shisty.
I mean, there's no instructions. I mean, maybe there are, but I'm not gonna read them. We'll just go ahead and wipe it new. You know what I mean? I love saying that. Sealage. Bro. Oh. Oh my God. The stench that came out of this tiny little bottle. Are you kidding me? It says to wear gloves. I'm not wearing gloves. Oh, wow. Oh, wow, okay. I mean, if it stays like this, come on, that's pretty awesome.
Can you guys see the difference right there?
Yeah, that's pretty good. For sure gonna get it on the hood, but it's the least of my worries, to be honest. Now, I'm not supposed to touch this for like an hour.
It's been about 10 seconds since I last spoke to you guys, and I told you it's gonna wait 30 minutes, but I'm impatient, so.
It's looking all right.
I mean, it's better. It's really hard to tell on camera, because like the sun and everything, but that side's real glassy, this side's kind of glassy. Might just go hit it again with the second little coat, but for now, that's good. Wipe new, you did all right. You know, that's what I gotta say about that.
Well, I mean, today was pretty solid. Got the engine bay clear coated and base coated, obviously. And looks pretty epic. I mean, like, it does not do justice on the camera. I took a picture of my phone, completely different. Like, I tried to set it to Cody, who owns the car, and I was like, dude, it looks so much better in person. But I mean, as far as like paint coming from a can, that's as good as you're pretty much gonna get. Like I said, I wish there was a little bit more reducer in the clear coat, but it is what it is. It's a whole lot cheaper than you if you were to buy like a thing of, you know, for actual a gun. Like it didn't. So if you guys want to take a full out paint job with a gun and it came out like glass, check out my whole video that I have. Today was a success. Tomorrow we have some things on the agenda. Maybe start to assemble the S12 engine bay back up a little bit, but I want to make sure it dries super good. And but yeah, I mean, as long as the weather permits, it should be pretty okay tomorrow. But we'll see what tomorrow brings. Tomorrow, a new video will be up at 5 p.m., guys, Eastern time. So I'll see you then. Later.